Hey friends, we are going to be building a tool that will display location data in Bing Maps using OpenEdge, and specifically version 12.6. OpenEdge is a platform that I recently came across. Well, not really recent, I would say it's been a few months now. I was blown away by their app dev platform and their advanced business language, ABL. So we are going to be using that to build today. I'll pull up on screen here OpenEdge so you can learn a little bit more about the tool we will be using. OpenEdge essentially supercharges enterprise app development so you are able to build dynamic multi-language apps with secure deployment. Let me pull up the project on screen here so you can see we have employee number, name, last name, phone number, and email. And this data is coming from the demo in OpenEdge, in their database specifically. If you go onto screen here, you can see we have a REST API that is returning the data for the employee data. So once again, the number, the name, last name, home phone number, and email address. Also too, I want to note that the demo I'm going to be going through today is one that was made in collaboration with OpenEdge. I just wouldn't feel right if I didn't shout out the amazing developers who work at Progress who developed the OpenEdge platform. Let's get into it. And before we dive into it, let's talk about some prerequisites, which are pretty standard for these type of things. And for this, we are using ABL as the programming language for the business logic on the server. Wait, Tiff, explain to me what exactly is an ABL stands for Advanced Business Language.
It's a language with its purpose to express business concepts
as efficiently as possible.
I was blown away by their application server, which they refer to as PaaS for OpenEdge. Also, for more information on PaaS for OpenEdge, I linked it down below.
We are adding these fields to the temp table definition so that this data can be returned from the application server. The OpenEdge ABL, the programming language in the Progress OpenEdge application platform, really makes things efficient. We do not need to even update the buffer copy statement as it already knows internally which fields can be copied.
The ABL language is tightly coupled to the database. So doing database operations like getting the customer data in this example is simply a matter of a for loop with a single line of code to fetch the data. Comparing this to other programming languages requires a bunch of line of code to do the exact same thing.
The next step is to have some prerequisites. As we are accessing Bing, we will need to set up an account and also to have a Bing Maps key. I'll link down below as well how you can follow along and get those. All right, if I open up VS Code here, you can see our HTML page. And also too, I want to note for this project, we are using Kendo UI. Kendo UI is a set of user interface components and tools that will allow you to build for both web and mobile applications. And it's based on HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. And Kendo UI is also developed at Progress. Also too, one of the main features or really interesting features about Kendo UI is its cross-platform compatibility. It allows you to build apps that work across different devices, browsers, including desktops, laptops, tablets, smartphones, you name it. All right, so let's go back to the HTML page. And you can see in the HTML file, we are importing grid.js. So if we go to the grid.js file, you will see there is a function here called create grid. And within that function, we are calling the REST API. Then if we scroll down a bit further, you can see we are creating a grid format and displaying the columns on the grid component. Next step is let's create a CLS file, and what that will do is really enhance the employee application.
Also, a CLS file is a source code file for ABL class definitions. It is a simple text file that can be opened in any text editor.
You can see here, this is the code that implements the REST API, and let's go ahead and add some fields. Latitude, longitude, position, but you can add more as well. And as you can see, we are adding these fields to the temp table definition so that this data can be returned from the application server. Next up, let's go back into our HTML code and ensure that we have support for Bing Maps. So you can see here on line 23, we have added in support for Bing Maps. Next, let's create a map.js file. And this map.js will do a call to the Bing Map Control API. Now in map.js, you can see we have the function called getMap. And this is where we will be creating an instance of the map object. So you can see we are creating map, Microsoft.maps map, and then two, passing in our credentials. Then this code is calling load data on line 22. And this function here is calling the REST API, as you can see. Then in our for loop, as you can see, it is adding the location information for each employee. And then this locations array is passed into the add locations function down below on line 43. And in the add locations function, you can see we are actually creating push pins for each location. Next up, we need to have a handler for the on push event that when you click on a push pin, it will display the info box. All right, if we go back to take a look at the new version, let's go back to localhost and see the new API that we have enhanced. We can see here it now includes latitude, it also includes longitude and position. And if you inspect this page and go to your network tab, you can see that this data is being returned as a JSON. Now, with all the steps we've taken, we can simply access our demo HTML page. To open your project now, right-click on the demo.html file and then open it up in Microsoft Edge. And there it is. This is pretty cool if you ask me. We were able to make this in a matter of minutes. You can see here now we have a Bing map, which really shows where the employees are located. And if you select one of these push pins, it will show the name and the title of the person. Okay, we have completed our project. This is pretty cool. Honestly, it's really simple and the power that OpenEdge brings is pretty incredible. And for this example, we were using JavaScript, but OpenEdge integrates with several programming languages, not just JavaScript. And also too, it provides a wide range of platforms and services from database management, application integration, security management, reporting, analytics, you get the point. It's really powerful. This is a platform that if you are developing independently, you can use, but also too, that a lot of businesses use. So it's something that is really important if you are going to be applying in the job market and you are looking for other platforms to learn. I would definitely suggest checking out OpenEdge because it's something that will really help you stand out on your resume. There are thousands of mission-critical applications written in ABL in multiple industries such as manufacturing, healthcare, travel, finance, and tons more. These applications are waiting to get extensions, improvements, and modernization, and also too, their users and customers need new developers. OpenEdge has a free developer training and certification program. I know a lot of us like to continue to upskill and gain more certifications to continue to grow our career, so I really wanted to share with you about this. This training will help you as a developer become certified in OpenEdge. Coding in OpenEdge doesn't have to be complicated. Also too, coding skills from other languages are transferable to ABL. I linked it down below, so make sure to go check it out. And once you have finished the training and are ready to jumpstart your career, OpenEdge even has a LinkedIn group that helps connect job-seeking developers with businesses that are specifically looking for OpenEdge developers. Let me know what we should build next. I wonder if we could like add on to this to track the employees as they move around. Or is that creepy? That's creepy, Tiff. Okay, hit the subscribe button. I'll see you all soon. Thanks everyone.